How you doing?
Let's give everybody a chance to come in. Actually, I'll have you guys, if you guys can make a half circle around here. Yeah, you guys can sit. You guys can sit. All right, if I can have everybody's attention. Good to see you. Where's the bus? Did you guys take the bus here? Oh, wait a minute. I heard the train. You guys took the train, right? How'd you get here? You walked here? Oh, wow. That's pretty awesome. You guys walked from Sycamore to Budenox. It's a beautiful day. It's good to see you.
That's the I've seen this place before, but I've never been here.
Well, let me tell you about this place. Before we get started, I want everybody to take a big, deep breath. And let it out. All right, one more. Yeah, Julia's not feeling well today, but I just want to welcome everybody with a nice, big bell. It's called a gong.
Ooh, let me tell you a little bit more about this.
No, it won't be too loud. So we just want to introduce you guys and say thank you for coming. And today, you guys are going to learn about gongs. You're going to learn about singing bells. You're going to learn about art. And we have a really good story. So I hope you enjoy your visit. So, you know how you guys walked from Sycamore to Budenox? There's a story of a man about 2,500 years ago. He was a young man, 26, 27 years old. He decided that he wanted to leave his village, and he went for a walk. And he ended up going to a tree called the Bodhi tree. And under that tree, he sat and he meditated, and he got very relaxed, and he became enlightened. His name was the Buddha. So as you look around the shop, you might see statues and figures of this guy named the Buddha. He's up there, and he is right here as well. So this guy is the Buddha. Yes. And he likes to be very relaxed, and he's very mindful, and he's always thinking. He became a really, really great teacher. So this shop is Charlotte's shop. She wanted to create a shop with singing bells, certain things about the Buddha to inspire people to meditate, to relax. One thing that people like to use is this. Does anybody know what it's called?
No. Yeah.
This is a singing bell.
Hey, wake me up.
Now listen very quietly. This is used for meditation. This is used for well-being. Sometimes people will hit their singing bell instead of taking things like aspirin or medicine, and it helps them get well. So I have a little quiz for you guys. I'm not sure how you're going to do, but we're going to see. Okay? Who's this?
Mickey Mouse.
You guys know who this is?
Yeah.
Okay. Who's this?
Buddha Mouse.
Good job. Yes. This is Buddha Mouse, and this is Charlotte's logo for the shop. That's why it's called Buddha Mouse.
Buddha Mouse.
Charlotte right here.
So it's a play on Buddha and Mouse. We're going to, in a minute, as we transition, every time we move to a different space, I'm going to hit this bell. And then we're going to go to a new area, and I'm going to teach you guys about art. And then we're going to go leapfrog into the story room, and we're going to read you a really, really nice story. Does anybody know what assemblage art is?
No.
Well, I think you guys do, because last week I saw that you made tree men, right, using art. So assemblage art is taking pieces and different things and using your imagination and creating art. Do you think we can make art with this?
Yeah.
What would you make?
It does look like a
hand.
You just put paper on that and stake it, tape, and color.
Yeah. So when we show you the art show, it's really about people. imagination. I see lots of stuff in this. I see like a mask and a horn. You guys are going to see a friend of mine. These are Riverwood taken from Mount Baldy. He made a tree out of these, so you guys are going to see that too.
Did you say River, my name?
Yeah, I did say it. So one other thing that I want you guys to know, this is assemblage art. So taking pieces, taking things, and this is a camera, and somebody took forks and spoons and iron and made art with it. So this is assemblage art. And it's really easy and really fun. So you guys can, you know what? Good question. This shop is, everything is for sale in this shop, except for some things, and you're always welcome to tell your parents about it. It's great to support your local businesses. Well, now she will. Okay, so listen up, member. That means we're going to transition, and we're going to go over to the gallery. Belle, raise your hand. Okay, you're sitting quietly. Go ahead and introduce the next lesson. You guys hear that?
No.
Okay, another deep breath. No. We're going to try to be like the Buddha and relax and be very still, because when we listen, we learn, right?
I can't do the Buddha right now.
That's okay. So this is the gallery. This is a show that's called Now in Zen. And Charlotte invites artists in our community to come and display their work. So this show was up the whole month of January, and it's going to come down today. So you guys are here on a very special day, because it's the closing reception. So we're going to have like a little party after we read the story. We've got tea and snacks. Did anybody spot the tree that I was talking about?
Yeah.
Isn't that cool? That's just like found wood from the river. And so as you look around, I'll talk a little bit about the other art. Who likes peanut butter and jelly sandwiches? Raise your hand. Julian's actually allergic to peanut butter and jelly sandwiches. So I made this piece.
I hate the flavor.
This is my assemblage, and it's kind of like peanut butter and jelly sandwich. I didn't make the actual candles, but I brought these things together and created this piece, and it's called Two Buddhas on a Teeter-Totter. And this is an old, rusty, antique teeter-totter. And I put two Buddhas on it.
This is a funny one. What is
this is a nice piece, too, that a friend carved out of burnt wood. So he made, like, a woman. And this one has a really great name. What would you guys call this?
Sword.
Sword? That's a good name.
It looks like a sword, though.
Anybody else want to guess a name? David? Oh, what's your name? Devin? What would you call this?
A stick?
A stick? Yeah, that's good.
A half woman.
Half woman? Oh, yeah. This is made by a local artist named Devin Goon, and he called it I Am a Rocket. I Am a Rocket. So the same guy who made that one there made this one here. It's like made out of styrofoam and glitter and glass, so a lot of things that you guys would do. This is made by my friend Cindy, very colorful, and the thing about art is it's open to your interpretation, so you guys can see art and whatever you feel about it. Sometimes that's what the artist is trying to relay. It's not always about, hey, look at that, don't you see that? Use your imagination. This is a new kind of art called Instagrams, and these are taken using cell phones, and then they actually send them to a company who makes canvases. Here's some other paintings. And then here's the kind of highlight that I wanted to show you about. Do you guys know Sienna at Sycamore? So her mom wanted to be in the show. So her mom is actually one of the artists who did a piece.
I know Sienna.
And Sienna saw her mom working on art, and she's like, I'm an artist. I want to be in the show. So she sent me that picture, and we said, yes, this is an amazing picture. And it kind of looks like Buddha blocks, but she called it sun, self, rain. And when you go to a gallery, anytime you see a red dot, that means that the art has sold. So we're really happy that she sold this. of art. Some art hasn't sold. This is one that Julian made. But as artists, sometimes when we put our pieces out there, it may not sell, and that's okay. I think the value, a lot of this show, is in people's hearts, the value and the work. They really got a lot out of it, so it was very, very well received. And sometimes in galleries, in museums, and so forth, things aren't for sale. Can you guys see that painting? And that was made by a woman who started carving this piece of wood, and it took her 6 years to do it. So as old as a lot of you guys are. And she only would carve the animals as she felt connected to the spirit of that animal. So if you look at that sculpture, you see various animals, you see dragonflies, butterflies. And then here's another assemblage piece, some you can touch. This one I call it Make Art, Not War. This is, anybody guess what this might be?
A tube?
Yeah, that one is a This is from a large bullet or a large ammunition. So this is a shell from a missile. So it's already kind of been spent, and instead of throwing away, it's nice to repurpose and reuse and recycle and make things useful again. So I took it and I added this little tray to it. So now that can be like a bird bath or something. And then I found this piece too. So we'll stick that on there. And that's art. And we'll call that Make Art, Not War. And it may not stick. Okay. One very important thing before we transition to... Yes, you have a question.
I can't see the other picture.
Okay. When we stand up and you guys transition into the next room, you'll be able to see it. I wanted to show you this piece for a certain reason, because when we had Julian do that piece, it took, and I like to call it, a process of practice, patience, and peace. So he started sketching, and we looked at different Buddhas, and we saw that kind of the Buddha's eyes were very kind of slanted, like he's sleeping, very big ears, exaggerated eyebrows. So Julian started making these things, and he crossed it out, and he made another one, and he crossed it out, and he made another one, and he crossed it out. He wasn't happy with it, and I said, you know what, this is part of the practice. Don't cross it out, just allow that, and that will then help you develop maybe your final piece. So I actually gave him a special Crayola paper, a special marker, and I took this little candle, and I said, here, use this as your example. Sometimes if we're not able to connect to our imagination, use examples or models. So he looked at that, and he sketched that, and it was done. I said, we'll use it. So he was happy with it. I'm like, what do you want to call it? And he's like, the Now Piece. And I was like, really? Why? And he didn't even know the name of the show, Now and Zen. He's like, Dad, because I just made it right now. So that's the Now Piece. So we'll have everybody stand up.
Well, it's not on the...